Hello viewers, welcome to Engineering Study Materials. Today we are going to discuss about the principles of material handling. First of all, what is a material handling? It is the movement of the materials or the products from one place to another. It is defined as the movement, storage, protection and control of the materials throughout the manufacturing and distribution process, including their consumption and disposal. So, what and why the material handling is performed? It is because safe transport and efficient transport of the materials, and it must be done at a low cost in a timely manner. That is, materials can be transported in a particular time so that it will be processed in the next departments, and accuracy and without damage to the materials. So these are all the 10 principles of the material handling. This must be followed while material handling in an industry or somewhere else. So first of all is planning, then standardization, work principle, ergonomic, unit load, space utilization, system, automation, environmental, and finally life cycle cost. So let's discuss planning principle. So when an operation is to be done, a plan is to be made accurately. All material handling should be the result of a deliberate plan where the needs, performance objectives and functional specification are completely defined at the outset. Because without a plan, any operation cannot be performed accurately or efficiently. The plan should be developed in consultation, because a planner and a user must be there in the planning session so that the plan will be clearly set and the operations can be efficiently done. The success in planning large-scale material handling projects generally requires a team approach involving the suppliers, consultants and end user specialists from management, engineering, computer and information systems, finance and operations. The plan should promote the concurrent engineering. Concurrent engineering is defined as the an engineering process that each department, that is a research department, design department, marketing, machining, manufacturing and marketing departments, can be collaborated with each other so that the final product can be performly designed and manufactured in a proper way, so that the final product can reach the customers in an efficient and a quality manner. So the plan should reflect the strategic objectives of the organization as well as the more immediate needs. Then standardization principle. All the parts are the raw materials, machines, workers used must be standardized. That is, all are set into a regular basic set of rules so that the product or the operation performing is made clear and accurate. So material handling methods, equipment, controls and software should be standardized within the limits of achieving overall performance objectives and without sacrificing needed flexibility, productivity, etc. So standardization applies to size of containers, operating procedures, equipments, variety of tasks under a variety of operating conditions, and in anticipation of the changing future requirements. Then work principle. Material handling work should be minimized. That is, large work should be minimized, but it would not affect the productivity or the producing capacity or the work of the industry. The work should be minimized in the way that it will not should be harder. It will be a smarter way so that the productivity is not produced minimally, but at the higher amount or the level of sacrifice required of the operation. Then simplifying the process by reducing, combining, shortening or eliminating unnecessary moves will reduce work. And gravity should be used whenever possible, because if you want to make the products transfer from an upper to a lower position or within a pipeline, say a liquid must be transported from a height of 50 meters to the ground level. So if you need a pump for the transferring of the liquid from upper to lower, there is no need of pump. The gravitational force can be used to transport that type of liquid movement. It moves the materials or to assist in their movement while respecting consideration of safety and potential for the product damage. And work principles are implemented best by appropriate layout planning. Then ergonomic principle. Ergonomics takes place a major role in the design process and in the manufacturing, because if you are producing a mobile phone, the mobile phone with sharp corners and without finishing can be given to a customer, means will the customer be happy with that mobile phone? No, not. It will be not handy and it will make damage to the customer because it will have sharp corners. So what is the need? The mobile should be handy with the smooth corner and the minimal thickness, so that it will be handy to the customers and the customer will enjoy the product. So human capabilities and limitations must be recognized. So what are the needs, the customer needs, and the design consideration are get from the customer by the means of the surveys, so that design can be processed. Ergonomics is the science that seeks to adapt work or working conditions to suit the abilities of the worker. First of all, safety is the major principle or a factor in the step of the ergonomic principle, and the ergonomic principle embraces the both physical and mental tasks. Equipment should be selected that eliminates repetitive manual labor. Then unit load principle. Unit load principle is simply called as, if you are producing 1,000 or 10,000 screws, bolts, nuts, etc., washers, they are the single unit parts. When we take all these parts and stored it in a single piece of a container and we carry it away, the carrying or the transfer of the single container is easy rather than the carrying of these small amounts of thousands of screws, nuts, washers, etc. This is simply called as a unit load principle. The parts are stored or moved as a single entity at one time, such as a pallet, container, regardless of the number of the individual items that make up the load. Less effort and work is the major task. And space utilization principle, that is effective and efficient way of using the space. This is simply called as a space utilization principle. In storage areas, the objective of the maximizing storage density must be balanced against accessibility and selectivity. When transporting the loads within a facility, the use of the overhead space should be considered as an option. The use of the overhead material handling system saves valuable floor space for the productive purposes. If you are running a car industry which will be somehow small space and storing the containers which are say 10 containers, the floor can only withstands 8 containers. The remaining 2 containers will not have a space. So what do you need to do is stacking of the container over and another container, so that you can save the floor space. And overhead space means in the form of a rail system, so that we can attach our containers to the rail system that will be situated for a small amount of time, so that we can save the floor space. Then system principle. Material movement and storage activities should be fully integrated to form a coordinated operational system that includes receiving, inspection, storage, production, assembly, packaging, unitizing, order selection, shipping, transportation, and handling of the returns. It will be in a system that consists of the all tasks in a center or a single department. The system integration should encompass the entire supply chain, including reverse logistics, that is the movement of the products from company to the user, or you from the user to the company. It should include the suppliers, manufacturers, distributors, and customers. The information flow and physical material flow should be integrated and treated as a concurrent activities. That is, the information can be flow from one department to another and other department to one department. And method should be provided for easily identifying materials and products, for determining their location and status within facilities and within the supply chain, and for controlling their movement. Then automation principle. This takes place a major important role in this type of industries nowadays, because if you are producing say 100 parts, some of the workers can be used in that industry so that they can be able to handle the parts from one place to another and can be process their parts easily. But in case if you are producing a running industry that is very large and you are producing the products such as lakhs and lakhs, so with the minimum amount of workers you cannot able to machine or market, package, material handling, etc. are difficult tasks. So that you will need an option that you may go to a automated principles, or you may take more amount of workers to the company. But taking the more amount of workers into the industry will decrease your profit, because you want to pay salary for those workers. But if you are performing the automation principles, profit will be more, and the materials or operations handling time will also be more, and operations can be quickly processed and delivered into the upcoming or next sessions. The material handling operation should be mechanized or automated where feasible to improve the operational efficiency, increasing responsiveness, improve consistency and accuracy. The items that are to be expected to be handled automatically must have the standard shapes. This is the major important features, because the automated machines are programmed, pre-programmed. For example, you say in a material handling or an assembly line, a square shape parts has to be flowed. But if an circular or some cuboid shape parts flowed, the material or a machine will not access or recognize that part and throw it. It is a defect. So this is the major task, because standard shapes only it will recognize and process. And computerized material handling system should be considered where appropriate for effective integration of material flow and information management. Then environmental principle. Environmental impact and energy consumption should be considered while designing or selecting the alternative equipments and material handling systems. Environmental consciousness should be made clear in upcoming industries or engineers, because environment is the place where we live and other animals or an ecosystem is set up. So we should not disturb those environmental factors, so that we should be feel safe. We do not waste natural resources, and to predict and eliminate the possible negative effects of our daily actions of the environment. Containers, pallets should be designed for reusability when possible and are biodegradability after disposal. Then finally, life cycle cost principle. A thorough economic analysis should account for the entire life cycle of the material handling equipment and resulting systems. The life cycle cost must be estimated properly so that the customers can buy that product for a long time, and the profit of the company will also be improved. So these are all the principles. So this is a short video, friends. If you like this video, put a thumbs up and share this video to your friends to gain knowledge, and don't forget to subscribe this channel for more videos. And so thank you for watching.